This one goes here.
After George finished episode 3, he got this idea to look at the films from the point of view of the stills, the individual frames. He felt that there were interesting works of design in each one of them. And his idea was to put it together in a book, and that was the genesis of how this all began.
I never really envisioned that George would actually go through the movies frame by frame, but we did. You're looking at, you know, probably a little under 200,000 frames per film. That's a lot of frames to look at. The first process was just to go through it and we'd mark frames of interest, if you will.
We got through episode 1, and then George chose roughly 700 frames for episode 1. I'd separate them all out, and then we'd meet in the conference room in the main house at Skywalker.
And we would then go through them all again, and he would throw out the ones that now, you know, sort of didn't make this cut.
After we did the same thing for episode 2 and episode 3, George sort of went back and started thinking, well, you know, there are certain beats we just have to have in there.
Each shot is designed to go opposite the other shot. And sequences are on 2 pages. If you have 3 shots in a sequence, then it's sort of, you have to figure out how that works out. And
if you can just imagine the process of sorting through hundreds of thousands of images before he ended up with these 1,416 images, it's quite a task. Not one that I think most filmmakers would embark on.
It definitely took over 2 years to get through all 6 films and for George to select all the images that he liked. It was a very interesting selection of photographs that George made, because some of them are kind of the expected, but then there's other things that are totally unexpected. There might be one frame that creates a really interesting image that he's pulled out that if you didn't look at it in context, you would have no idea that it came from a Star Wars film.
What George wanted was the full cinematic format. And when you see those pictures at the size we've created them, you get a unique view into that world.
It's unbelievable the amount of people who go into making the movies. And when you go through frame by frame, you really see just how much work and dedication went into every single, literally, frame of the movie.
The books are hand-sewn and inserted into a Japanese silk cloth-bound slipcase. George had a certain vision that these books would go into kind of a trunk. We came up with this beautiful inlaid case, which on each side has sculpted figures of Darth Vader and Yoda.
We've limited the edition to 1138, obviously a tip of the hat to THX, George's first film. That means that there's not very many that will ever be produced in the world. It's the only official product that we've released that is signed by George. It comes with a certificate of authenticity. It is a very unique and exclusive keepsake and memento for this phenomenal achievement that George had in the films. In the end, I think what we've created, in which George has, you know, poured a lot of his heart and soul into, it is a truly unique work of craftsmanship and an essential part of the Star Wars saga.
For those lucky few who will be able to collect these books, they're going to have the ultimate Star Wars book. There'll never be, I think, anything else like this.
It is the ultimate collector's piece.